Hello everyone, and welcome back to a brand new quick tip by JANUS Engineering. This month we are taking a closer look into another tip when it comes to specifying cut areas. Let's explain the scenario. We are machining this part, specifically the walls within the cavity. We are finishing the sidewalls, but here comes the catch. All the gray walls must have a set stock of 0, but the green ones are supposed to have a different set stock than the rest. So how can I add stock to the individual walls within the same operation? In our last video, we explained how to select walls quickly using our Remove Selection tool. So we'll use this tool to select all the walls as tangent, then use the Remove Selection intent to get rid of the selected floors. As I was saying, we want to be able to have the gray walls have one stock, but the green walls have a different stock. In the cut area, we are able to add in custom data. We open this up and you can see that we can add a stock in here. So we'll add a custom stock of an eighth inch, but this stock is now set for all of the selected walls, and that's not what we want to accomplish. So we'll get rid of this stock, and then to select some of the surface, we are going to right-click on the 133 walls and expand them. This causes NX to split all the individual walls into single faces and cut areas. They are all now listed below and can be selected one by one from here. You can still select the walls based on clicking them. NX will naturally detect where this wall is located in the list. So, to add stock individually, we'll select one of them, and then we'll select our stock, turn it on, and then we can add that eighth inch. We're going to repeat this for the other two walls as well. As you can see, the stock is already set to an eighth inch here, and all we had to do is select the stock to be turned on. And the same with the last one. Now that all three walls have stock on them, we can see that in the list below, there's custom data provided at those specific walls. All the rest of the walls will remain with no custom data. All right, we can click OK, and then we will generate our toolpath. Once we actually get the result, we'll be able to click in on this toolpath and have our tool appear. We can see when we zoom in that there should be no stock left on this wall in between the wall and the tool. Do the same thing on this green wall, and we can see that there's just a little bit. It's hard to see from this angle though. So a better way to do this would be to use sections. A bonus quick tip for you. We'll go to view and then create new section. And then we will snap this to the correct location and then our correct direction. Now when we click OK here, we can go back into our area mill and we can add our tool. We'll make this straight for you real quick. Then we can zoom in and we can see that there is that eighth inch gap there. We'll do the same thing, except we'll do the gray walls this time. We're going to move our wall, snap our correct view. And then when we zoom in and straighten this out for you, get the tool back in here real quick. You'll be able to see that there is no stock being left on the part. The part and the tool are actually touching. Well, all right, that is it for this week's quick tip. Thanks for watching. As always, make sure to subscribe and like our channel to never miss our monthly tip. Have a good one. Bye-bye.